everyone, this is Arnoud, whizbiz.com. And in this video, let's talk about these small circuit boards. These are circuit boards with sensors. The boards come with a wide variety of sensors, can be purchased online for very little money. Well, we might call them sensor boards. And because these are, well, mainly designed for use with 5-volt microcontrollers, it's quite easy to use them with a microcontroller, like a universal board such as the Arduino, the Microbit, the ESP32, or a Raspberry Pi, where there's 5 volts around. But as you probably know, I like to build my mechanical prototypes and industrial quality models with fischertechnik. And then you will encounter some incompatibility when you want to use these sensors. Then it would be at least convenient if in the prototyping and experimentation phase you could also use the sensor boards. But looking at fischertechnik, both their vintage electronic modules, these so-called Silberlingen, as well as their more modern controller solutions like the TXT controller, are all in the 9-volt domain. They work on the same 9-volt their peripherals should, and their inputs are in the 0 to 9-volt range, making it quite difficult to use these sensors with fischertechnik controllers or modules without modification or additional electronics. So, because I would like to use these sensor boards with these controllers and electronic modules, I thought about developing a universal adapter board for them. If I had such a board, it would greatly improve the compatibility and applicability of these sensor boards, and even better if it could also facilitate the rather different pin order of all these 3-pin connectors on the various boards. Why? Well, because the pinout differences between those modules are quite large, are really quite large here. For instance, the signal output of this module is on the side, and with this one it's in the middle. Also, the order of the plus and minus connection is really quite random. With 3 pins, I think there are around 6 possible sequences, and I've really seen them all. You can, of course, narrow down the number of possibilities a bit more by considering placing the PCBs upside down, but of course, if there are any components like this potentiometer on the PCB that needs to be accessible, mounting the whole thing upside down will not be an option. So if I could design an adapter PCB to mount these sensors to, it could also directly provide the lower supply voltage for the sensor boards and allow them to be connected to, for instance, 9 volts or 12 volts and provide the necessary 5 volts for the sensor boards. And another thing would be that it would allow me to connect them directly with these traditional 2.5 millimeter fischertechnik plugs if I had any holes or connectors for them or buses for them on the PCB. And of course, it would even be better if I could also use passive sensors like a read switch like this one, or a push button, or a vibration sensor that, in other words, sensors that are not even fitted to a PCB or need an active power voltage to work. In other words, would it be possible to design some kind of an adapter PCB that I can just throw all these sensor boards at and it would facilitate any of them with any possible pin layout of the board? Besides that, one of the key features of the future adaptive board must be that it would handle a higher voltage, between 9 and 12 volts, to be used on these boards. So there must be some kind of voltage regulator on the board to provide the necessary 5-volt power of the sensor boards. With that, the sensor boards might be used on the inputs of the regular microcontrollers and the fischertechnik TX and TXT controllers. But for use with these Silberlingen, however, we still need to connect a so-called Grundbaustein, like this one in between, to make the output signal level detectable. But there is another thing. There is a big difference between the high input impedance of a microcontroller, or a fischertechnik controller as you like it, and these generic electronic modules. Microcontroller inputs draw very little current and actually only sample the voltage level offered by the connected sensor output. Whether a logical high or active signal is represented by 5 volts or 0 volts is even irrelevant there, because after all, the logical interpretation of the physical output levels can easily be adjusted in the software. Not so with these digital electronic modules, of course. These Silberlingen, for instance, are electronically constructed according to the so-called diode transistor technique, and logical levels are measured with current flow instead of voltage levels. The output of the sensor boards cannot deliver this. Their logical output signal is represented by a voltage level, and that's unable to pull the input of such an input to an adequate zero level. So, let's see what our ideal universal adapter must be able of. First of all, it has to facilitate the connector pinouts, all the differences in these connector pinouts of the available sensors. Then it must have some kind of voltage regulator to enable us to supply 5 volts to the sensor board, while accepting a more flexible input range of the voltage up to, I guess, well, 12 volts would be nice. Another thing is, it would have a current controlled rather than voltage controlled output, so we can also use it with the classic electronic modules or in a digital way directly in normal conventional electronics. Then it would be nice if it provides the normal digital output signal as well as the complementary output signal, so the inverted output signal. Should the sensor board does not have any indicator LEDs, it would be nice if we could add them ourselves to the PCB, to the adapter PCB. And it would be nice if it also facilitates simple passive switching components such as a push button, read contact or tilt switch. And what would finally make it so much more useful within the fischertechnik community would be if it also enables you to use the regular fischertechnik wires and plugs. So it should have some buses for the 2.5 millimeter fischertechnik plugs. Alright, so here we have the schematic I came up with. It shows the universal adapter boards, with which I hope all the above requirements will be met to ensure optimum compatibility with the classic fischertechnik electronic modules. The original electronic design of their output stage was taken as a starting point over here. That original design also adds the inverted signal with a second transistor over here. Here on the left is where the higher voltage, 9 volts, comes in. A simple short circuit protection device is the diode I have included here. And I also use the well-known 5 volt voltage regulator, the 78L05, which turns it into 5 volts over here. Oh, a small word about these capacitors. I don't think they're really necessary, but at least I reserved a spot on the PCB for them, I guess. Also for an electrolytic capacitor, just in case. I can imagine that there is some noise when motors are driven from the same supply voltage, for example. And an extra little noise filtering will never hurt. Probably not necessary in practice. Over here, we have the various three pin connector positions that I think would facilitate just about any sensor board pin layout I came across up till now. And there are also two contacts over here which facilitate connecting a passive switching component such as a wired push button or a read contact, for example, so that we can also use them. And over here is the logical output stage, both a Q and a non-Q. And I've also included a second connection option here with small white GST connectors. Both the power supply connection over here and the GST connectors here are doubled, so there are two of them identical. If I position them on the opposite side on the PCB layout in a moment, we can easily loop through the power if we use multiple of these modules in a row. Alright, so here we have the final PCB that I got produced with the voltage regulator and the output electronics in SMD technology already soldered on. After mounting the sensor of choice, it might be used just like this with the 2.5 millimeter plugs of fischertechnik, but of course you could also fix some additional GST connectors if you would like to connect it that way. The sensor board of choice is simply soldered in the appropriate connection position, and there are a few here. Both the fischertechnik connector holes in the board and the optional GST connectors are doubled on both sides of the PCB, so that enables you to loop through the power of the server or sensor modules easily. The Q and not Q outputs are not to be looped through, of course. These are not some kind of bus, these are just unique for the specific board. Most of these sensor boards come with these angled, soldered on 3-pin connectors. And in some cases you might find a spot with the correct pin sequence and mount a female connector on the PCB and plug it in. But you might consider a little preparation of the board. In most cases I prefer to remove the original mounted connector and make the connection to the board with 3 short wires myself. And for finally fixing the sensor board to the adapter board, I achieved very good results with a glue gun with hot glue. In this way, even this water sensor could be securely mounted. Passive sensors such as the vibration sensor, a loose or separate read contact, or a wired push button can be connected between these outer positions A and H on this schematic diagram, and the various 3-pole terminals provide a range of connection options for the active sensor boards that require an active 5-volt power supply. So the blue position A through H indicate the possible connection points for the possible sensor boards. You just fit it where it fits. And the optional electrolytic capacitor, which can be soldered to the underside of the board, is shown in gray because it's only optional. The LED at the outputs are also optional and therefore also shown in gray. They're not needed if the sensor board already has its own indicator LEDs. Because I wanted to use the sensor board with the fischertechnik system, I designed some variations of the holder for the PCB with the typical fischertechnik mounting grooves. So for now there is a model with slits to accommodate the PCBs with the GST connectors, and one for the modules that only need the traditional fischertechnik connection and doesn't have the GST connectors. The PCB is mounted with a few small 6mm M2 screws. Please follow the links in the description of this video to the project page where I've documented all the different sensor board positions on this adapter PCB. There are positions for LDR, infrared obstacle, temperature sensor boards, as well as the LED touch switches, but also locations for the vibration and motion sensor boards, the Hall effect sensor boards, humidity sensor, this small passive infrared motion sensor, etc. A module with a passive infrared motion sensor already came in handy for starting an LED demonstration. This module starts a small light show as soon as an interested party walks up to the table, for instance on a convention. The model is controlled with an Arduino Mega Pro Mini, where the various LED traffic lights are powered by a few modules with short circuit proof driver outputs. But with the adapter boards discussed here, it's just as easy to build such a control with a TXT controller or even with the traditional electronic modules like the Silberlingen. In the past, I used the infrared obstacle sensors to measure rotational speed by building these double tachometer myself. This is a tachometer with the Hall effect sensor in the adapter module. A movement of the magnet along the sensor triggers a hardware interrupt that allows the rotation speed to be determined and measured. So there you have it. The adapter module is already proving its worth in various models. More information, photos, and a link to a video can be found on the project page online. The 3D print files of some variants of the holder I designed for the adapter prints are available for download for anyone who wants to print them or have them printed. So just follow the links in the description of this video to my project page, to the GitHub, or to any other place where you can find more information about this project. And when you're on whizbiz.com, just take a look at my electronics catalog to see how I can help you. Well, that's about it for this time. Hope to see you with my next video. Until then, let's say happy hacking!